Hello and welcome to NewsClick. Today we are joined by Dr. Yogesh Jain of the Jan Swasthya Sahyog, and we are going to be talking about the COVID-19 lockdown, rapid testing, as well as what kind of quarantine measures need to be done. So Yogesh, Dr. Yogesh, thank you so much for joining us. So first of all, I'll start with the recent controversy over the antibody testing kits. The Delhi High Court yesterday declared that it was being sold at too high a price to the government. Meanwhile, almost around the same time, the ICMR said that they were actually cancelling the permissions, the contract, because apparently the quality was not good enough. So this has been a big issue because we've all been talking about the need to test more, and then we have rapid testing kits themselves proving faulty. So has there been a failure in terms of actually evaluating what exactly were the kind of kits needed and how they should be procured, considering there has been an issue on the quality front and the price front?
So I think this is symptomatic of the problems that are there when one is managing an epidemic of this proportion, where we don't get our act together of how to govern various components of our work. In this case, you know, the Indian Council of Medical Research, that is otherwise, given the work of conducting medical research on issues that come up before the country. In this case, could be how to diagnose the disease correctly, what are the treatments that should be given,
right?
How should data be maintained? Now, this function of ICMR, certainly they should have focused and kept on that. But ICMR was also burdened with the task of, you know, in this case, also procuring the type of kits, choosing the kits, not only validating those kits, and because of this. They seem to got themselves into a tangle where they didn't decide. They couldn't. They were even asked to fix the rates and choose the company from where to buy, and this only stopped once they realized that the kits that came in, the first two kits at least. We know there are several more in the pipeline. Those did not in the validation test that they did first up. But that was a little delayed after, you know, the kits had been already dispatched to two states in the country.
Right.
And then the results of those validation did not, were not enthusiastic, were not encouraging enough to continue testing on them, and they have been withdrawn. But in the process, the tangle regarding procuring of the kits at prices which were higher than they should have been, mm-hmm. and allowing, you know, profiteering for certain companies that fought with each other.
Right.
And finally, having to face this problem of returning these kits now.
Exactly.
While, you know, this could have been done easily by another arm of the government, which is involved in the procurement of such equipment and reagents in quick time. This was not something that would instill faith and, you know, respect from the large society, which
right.
is at the moment dealing with the problem of the pandemic.
Absolutely. And do you think that this is going to probably have an impact on our larger preparedness itself? Because rapid testing was seen as one of the key components, at least by many states, definitely in evaluating the status of the lockdown also.
Well, I would say, you know, the entire diagnostic workup of patients with presumed COVID is still unsettled.
Mm-hmm.
We have had problems with the PCR test, the RT-PCR that we do for diagnosis of active disease,
mm-hmm.
which has its own problem because it is not very sensitive. You know, it's only 63% sensitive. And the testing criteria has always been a subject of debate with us for the last few weeks. And this, the antibody test, which is the antibodies that appear in blood, they usually appear a week later,
right.
and sometimes 10 days later. And their primary function that was expected of them of tests, which were to pick up people's antibodies in blood, were for surveillance purpose.
Exactly.
Which could allow one to know what is the burden of disease in a particular community or in certain sets of high-risk people like health workers.
Right.
or people who come with a specific severe respiratory infection to hospitals of this country, would have allowed us to plan first who will be the first line health workers who would be looking at problems when people come to hospitals from among the large mass of health workers, to choose the most protected people. Mm-hmm. The second thing was it would have allowed us the trends in the burden of disease in a particular district would have allowed us to choose in a more granular method processes of social distancing, including lockdowns and right. controlling movements of people, movement of goods, and also allow us to take other public health decisions about how many beds to create, how many people how many beds do we need for quarantining, how many beds we require for isolation, and so forth. But now this might push back these things, this problem about kids might push it back by a few weeks. Mm-hmm. But I hope, at least I know that in Chhattisgarh, the antibody test kits from South Korea have, as yesterday, have shown promise. Mm-hmm. And in fact, Chhattisgarh is going ahead with this surveillance methods within this week itself.
Right.
Doing it at district level now. Mm-hmm.
So just to elaborate a bit more on this process, because many states are thinking about easing some restrictions, and that's probably the most significant question on people's minds. So how do we see the lockdown slowly being eased? First of all, are we in a position to think of it, or at least are most states in a position to think of it? And if we are, how exactly, so what should be the medical processes involved?
Well, I think it's locking up a set of people or entire people of a country or a mm-hmm. state. Actually is positing the problems of life and health due to COVID and non-COVID illnesses against livelihoods of people, which are itself an important determinant of health state of a people. So, and therefore people have had to do a balancing act about not allowing major effect on livelihoods, so that people's other patterns, other systems of life, other aspects of life, which means education, means future of people, actual everyday eating and, other needs are looked at. And at the same time, strike a balance at a societal level to accept a certain amount of morbidity and mortality mm-hmm. Due to COVID and non-COVID illnesses. So in fact, knowing about the burden of disease in a particular area and calling them as by various names, which have their own problems like hotspots right. and containment areas,
red zones and stuff,
have problems. But I would say overall we are not in a situation. We are not a country with a very formal economy, with a lot of people who live from day to day. That we cannot have a lockdown that we have had now for 40 odd days mm-hmm. continuing for any longer.
Right.
We will have to go into a mitigation strategy where we minimize the damage that is mm-hmm. done to people's health because of COVID-related illnesses or due to even the non-COVID-related illnesses. We don't want to give people a choice that either you die of COVID or you die of tuberculosis, which is not looked after.
Exactly.
So we need our health systems to start running again, as well as we need our people's economies to to be not damaged any more than what they have been done in the last few weeks.
Right.
And I would argue that we should be able to accept a certain amount of damage due to COVID-related illnesses to happen. You minimize that to the extent that we can do with whatever our health systems are,
right.
but not damage other reasons which are more in our control, is like livelihoods and non-COVID related healthcare.
Absolutely. And finally, so there's a question of once, for instance, we do start looking at, say, easing some restrictions, there is a possibility of the number of cases rising, or if not massively by a steady rate, the number of cases still is continuing to rise. So there's also the question of, say, at a time when, say, restrictions are eased, what kind of quarantine measures do we, as a government, as a society, do we look at instituting? Because how do we, for instance, sort of ensure that certain sections are not cracked down upon very strongly so that the rest of society continues as normal. So what kind of measures and what kind of thinking needs to go into that?
I would say that first we should be protecting people from non-COVID illnesses, consequences, the bad consequences of people dropping out of treatment for tuberculosis, not being able to seek treatment for tuberculosis,
right,
or people's treatments for cancers not being disrupted anymore, their treatment for other chronic illnesses like diabetes, hypertension, asthma, joint diseases, mental illnesses not being disrupted anymore, and women and childhood illnesses problems should be looked after as well as they were, or even better than what we had before we started having the problem of COVID.
Right.
But at the same time, I would say that we need to allow people to be able to access these services, which would mean that we have to have public transport going again.
Exactly.
Going on. We need our auto rickshaws, we need our buses, we need our trains to run so that people can, you know, access care.
Mm-hmm.
How many people in this country can travel by their own transport to public services, to public health services? I don't think it's more than 20% of people who can afford to either use a cycle of their own or a bus or a car or motorcycle of their own. Most people depend upon public transport to be able to access health care, certainly secondary level health care. So we need public transport, and I think that itself, and in the absence of, you know, allowing big gatherings of people, we should pretty much open everything else where people, I think, are sensible enough to be able to maintain whatever distancing that they can do from each other, as well as look after their own hygiene of hands and of their faces, so that they protect themselves from this virus that we have in our midst,
right,
but at the same time not allow other problems to happen.
Right. Thank you so much, Dr. Yogesh, for talking to us.
Thank you.